students, welcome to lecture series of automobile engines. In today's session, we will discuss about what is injector and what is nozzle and what are the different types of nozzles. Fine. So let's start our video. So let me give you a simple introduction what are the nozzles are. So nozzle is a part of injector through which the fuel is actually injected into the combustion chamber. Thereafter, the design of nozzle should be such that all the criteria that we discussed we should be fulfilled. Fine. And the types of nozzles which are currently used in injector depends upon the types of combustion chamber also, fine, which is used in the engine. So the combustion chamber is first designed, thereafter its nozzle is designed, and we will mix it both of them for the optimization process, fine. So what are the different types of nozzles are there? So basically there are four types of nozzles. First is pintle nozzle, second one is single hole nozzle, thereafter multi hole nozzle, and for fourth one is pintux nozzle. There is also one more type, that is circumferential nozzle, but it's in general type like a multi-hole nozzle. Fine. So these are main four nozzles which are used right now in a injectors. So this is the figure of all the four. Let me explain you one by one. So the first one is, that is pintle nozzle. We will see it later. First let me show you what is a single hole nozzle. Fine. So first one, why single hole nozzle? Because it is having only one hole. Fine. So the needle pin will be there inside that hole and injection will be done due to the liftment of that needle. Fine. So there is only one hole. So what is that? The hole diameter will be almost 0.2 mm. Now these criteria are very important. Fine. So in that case you need to cover up what is there inside that nozzle. Fine. So the single hole is actually a bore, or single hole is bored at bottom ring of the nozzle. Second one, there is only 0.2 mm of the diameter of the hole. Third one, whenever the spray will come out, it will actually form cone shape. Fine. So if I'm spraying like this, it will form cone shape inside the combustion chamber of the fuel. So fuel get distributed all over the combustion chamber. Fine. So what is happening here? The spray cone angle obtained, it is in the range from 5 degree to 20 degree inside this single hole nozzle. These are the main specifications that you need to remember inside the single hole nozzle. Fine. Now, second one, that is, what are the advantages of it? So first one, that is, it is suitable for open combustion chambers. Fine, that was the first advantage. And what is disadvantage is, it gives very small spray angle. So if your cylinder is very large, it will be easy, it will be better to use multi-hole nozzle in place of single hole nozzles. Fine. And second one, it has tendency to dribble because there is only one hole. So whenever fuel will go from it, it can be a chance that fuel can be restricted there, or it remains there. The whole fuel will not go outside of it. Fine. So that is its disadvantage inside the engine. Fine. So it is a single hole nozzle. Second one, that is multiple hole nozzle. Now it is having the same specifications like that, only change in numbers. Fine. So in place of single hole, there are multiple holes, which is even at a circumference of this or tip of the nozzle. Fine. First one, the holes can be vary from 4 to 8. In many cases, there can be 8 to 12 also. Fine. Depending on the combustion chamber and its size. Fine. Thereafter, the diameter of the hole, it also varies from 0.2 to 0.35. Fine. Now, what is advantage of it? So, it ensures the proper reaching of the fuel in the combustion chamber, because now holes are high. Holes numbers are high. Fine. So, everywhere there is hole for each area of the combustion chamber. So larger area can be covered inside this combustion chamber by this multiple hole nozzle. Fine. Now what is advantage of it? So it ensures the proper mixing of fuel inside the combustion chamber. And what is disadvantage is, so it requires high injection pressure because number of holes are higher. Fine. So pressure will be actually distributed among all the things. So we need high pressurized fuel injection in this nozzle to operated. Fine. So it requires high injection pressure in the range of 180 to 200 bar inside the nozzle. Third one, that is pintux nozzle. Now why this pintux nozzle? But let me show you what is pintle nozzle. Thereafter we will see pintux nozzle. So what is pintle nozzle? It is having a simple construction just like single hole, but little bit different from the single hole. Fine. So what is here? So it is having the keen end in the form of pin. So here you can see there is no hole. Fine. It is actually a pin. You can see this section. There is one pin, right? in a single hole there was something like this section, there was a needle, fine. But here it is pin, so you can see this area, here it is pin, fine. So what is happening here, this pin will actually push the fuel whenever there is a dribbling condition, fine. So whenever fuel will remain inside this hole, this pin will actually push the fuel to the combustion chamber. So dribbling will not happen, fine. It is almost the same as single hole nozzle, but it actually overcome the problem of dribbling inside it, fine. So what is happening, its specifications are, it is having a thin end in form of the pin. Thereafter, the shape of the pin can be varied, fine, we can use any of the shape to reduce the dribbling effect. And third one is hollow cylinder jet or a wide angle spray that can be opted, fine. So these are the main specifications that we are using. And what is the advantage of it? So advantage is like, it avoids the dribbling of fuel in the combustion chamber, so the dribbling will not happen here. So whenever you are using single hole, you can also use pintle nozzle to overcome the effect of dribbling inside it. Now what is dribbling? Let me tell you again. Whenever you are using nozzle, when the fuel injection ends, some of the fuel particles will remain inside the nozzle. It will not go to combustion chamber, and it is called dribbling effect. Fine. We need to import. We need to import everything inside the combustion chamber. Any fuel particle should not remain inside the nozzle. That was the main criteria. Fine. So that we are using this pin belt to push all the fuel particles inside the combustion chamber. Now there is also one more nozzle. That is last one. It is pin tops nozzle. Now why the pin tops nozzle? Because it is actually used for the dribbling effect, fine. So dribble will actually reduce very much in this portion. There is also an auxiliary hole. It is same as pintle, fine. So what is happening here? It is same as pintle, fine. But what is different here? There is auxiliary hole inside it. You can see this auxiliary hole, fine. So what is happening here? From this auxiliary hole, the fuel can also get outside in the combustion chamber. So what are the specifications? Let's see. So the pintle type of nozzle with an auxiliary hole drilled in it. There is one auxiliary hole. And second, this hole injects the fuel in the direction upstream the direction of the air before the main injection starts. So why we are giving this? Because now it is used to reduce ignition delay. Now what is ignition delay? So whenever there is air, we are adding some fuel. So fuel will go inside it. It will get mixed with the air, it will take temperature of air, and thereafter it will start burning. So these four steps are actually done when we inject fuel and when the fuel ignition is happening. Let me repeat, when we inject fuel and the fuel ignition happens, fine. And this time between both of them is called ignition delay. Now why this delay occurs? Because whenever we are injecting, it is not directly starting ignition. It will go inside it. It will be mixed with it, it will take its temperature, then after it will start to ignite. So what is the logic behind this pintop nozzle? We are actually injecting some amount of fuel before the real injection, fine. So actually you know that from this nozzle, that from this hole the real injection starts, fine. So whenever we are using pintop nozzle, what we will do? We will inject some amount of fuel from this auxiliary hole before the main injection. So what is happening now, fuel is already there inside before the main injection. So the ignition delay will not occur. So whenever we are injecting a real fuel, or you can say whenever we are doing the main injection, the ignition delay is already reduced because fuel is now already mixed and the temperature is also achieved inside it, which is nearby the self ignition temperature of diesel. So what is happening here, we are injecting a fuel from this auxiliary hole first, so it will reduce ignition delay. Now we are injecting from the main nozzle, ignition delay will not be there. So to reduce the ignition delay, for the better heat transfer between air and fuel, we are using this pintop nozzle, fine. It is actually different from all the nozzles, so it is very useful to reduce ignition delays. And second one, the result is also better in cold starting performance because we are providing extra fuel, fine. So in cold starting condition, it will make ratio reach. So what is happening? The vehicle will start faster than the other nozzles. It is also one type of nozzle that we are using in our engines, fine. So pintop nozzle is one of the best nozzles in four of them. So you have seen all these four nozzles. Let me quickly revise. What are the four nozzles? One was pintop, then single hole, multi hole, and pintop nozzle. And all these nozzles work depending on its construction, right? So that's it in today's session. In next session, we will see about different types of mechanisms in a diesel engine, fine? That's it.